Hey there, guys, gals, fans, and pals. Your buddy John Megacycle here. Another episode of Shapes.io coming at ya. Let's just do a quick recap of where we're at, what we're doing, what we're aiming for. I believe we are still working on this happy little pupper here, half green, half cyan scimitar star bonanza. That's what I'm naming that guy right there. No idea. But yeah, we've been working on trying to get some of these pieces together to get up in the higher tiers, start unlocking upgrades, and all the like. This is going to unlock a chaining extractor, not sure what that is, but also better cutting, rotating, and stacking for our tier 3, which is exactly what I'm looking for. We've been moving really quite quickly through the tech tree. I don't really have any other real fine points for us to bring up other than, yeah, we're motoring. I've got all our objectives here pinned on the left. Let's go ahead and take a gander where we were. I got my latest. There we go. Cool. I stepped away from the computer for a bit, so I didn't know exactly where we were, but now we're here. So we've got our cyan star. We've also got our half circle-y do. So this is going to be a whole lot of cut and rotate. I'm pretty sure I can sacrifice this red. So I want 8 total, I think. That smells like 8. That smells like 8. Okay. Real simple. Get these all looking like that. Ah, yes, the beautiful glow. No! Damn belt. And a little something. Nope. Nope. Not quite. Not quite. There we go. That's also not quite what I wanted. That's okay. As I mentioned before, these belts are a little sticky, little iffy. You gotta coax them a little bit. Okay. So what does that leave us with? Let's just run a quick check here. So I need these parts to be on the bottom. So let's see. That'd be a counterclockwise rotation out of this guy. And a clockwise rotation out of this guy. Does that sound right? Perfect. Okay, cool. Let's just stamp a few of these things down here. And let's balance this back out. Is the balancing necessary all the time? Probably not. I just like to rebalance stuff. It prevents any real bottlenecks, I guess. Well, I guess it doesn't stop them from happening, but it does help even out production lines. Okay, so I have a boatload of these things, and we're ready to combine with those. So let's get the stacker going on. I don't know how many. 8. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, I guess. Let's just get right to it. I don't really have a whole lot of planning for this one. Just slap it in, call it a day, right? We are going to do our staggered approach to make this a little easier on us, and what we're aiming for is the 2-gap. That 2-gap there is what allows us to get our underneathies where we want them, and this is just gonna be gravy. This is just gonna be all gravy. There's not gonna be a whole lot of forethought here. 2-step gap. 2-step gap. Oh, actually, I see what a problem is. I think I've lined these up incorrectly. Actually, I've got capacity for 16. Should we go for 16? What the hell, right? Let's do it. Oh, wow. Okay. This project just got a lot more massive than I had anticipated, but that's okay. It literally just doubled. Amazing. This is why we ask for spacing every time. It doesn't matter what kind of a game you play. If spatial reasoning is involved and you need some space, if you need to make sure you need to reconcile for terrain or area or bad guys or whatever, give yourself the space. This is bananas. Okay. That's all hooked up. Now we have to hook up all this rigmarole. Okay. That's not gonna fly. That's okay. Let's just leave that one alone. So we're gonna do something like this all the way through, and then the circly boys can just pop right down the middle. Okay, and then for this part, look at that, easy, right? A new upgrade's available. Extraction, excellent sauce. Oh my god, more of this stacking stuff. I don't even want to know. I don't even want to know. I kind of want to know, but I don't even want to know. Okay, and this goes like that. Okay, now let's take a gander and see if the sides matter. Because I think we already established it doesn't. Nope, cool. We get the piece we want. Brilliant stuff. Okay. Where the hell is the hub? The hub is over there. How am I going to hook this in? Oh, very easily. Okay. I'm just going to do something like this. I kind of want to get the parts moving right now. I'm a little impatient. To be honest. I should clean that up a bit, but we can clean it all up later. How close am I to think? Okay, I'm actually very close. Yeah. Okay. So something like that. And we'll just stamp that down the rest of the way. Nope. Yep. And then I think another combinery dude. So what's the game plan here? Am I getting this all to just one thing? Maybe. I'm gonna need some really fast belts to handle all this, that's for sure. Okay. I wish it was a mini-map radar kind of a thing, so I could kind of keep track of where my stuff is at. Nope, too high. A little too high still. Bingo. Okay, so we only have two things going. I almost kind of want to just stagger this in and just kind of observe. That, yep, real simple. Real simple. We already have the framework down. So this is not a lot of brain thinky power. This is pretty straightforward here. Just tons and tons of belts. And tons of underneathies. Could probably combine and re-split these lines, now that I'm thinking about it. Because we're not going to have 100% compression anyhow. But I'm going to leave it as is, I think. Yeah, see how the line isn't full at all? We kind of discussed that last episode, where I could have just combined this to one and then split it up there. That might have been smarter, but this works as well. Now, we could do is we could just rebalance it here. I mean, there's a lot of stuff we can do. Whether or not it's worth our time, I'm not sure. Just not sure. But that's okay. Upgrades will come and go, and they will help our production quite well. So not super duper worried about it. Oof, there we go. Gotta zoom in a bit. All that zoomed outedness was cool, but it was actually starting to hurt my eyes a little bit. So many pretty colors and so many pretty shapes. Okay. Okay, how are we looking now? Not bad. Actually, just two more is going to fully saturate this belt, I think. Which is okay. That's not going to be the case the very second we get another speed belt upgrade. Cool. The autosave is every 2 minutes, I think. Which is good. Maybe that's a little too frequent. I think in Factorio I have it to like 10 minutes or 15 minutes or something. But this game, since nothing costs, I can just slap down tons and tons of stuff in very short order. I'm not waiting. Again, this is not an idle game. We're not supposed to be just waiting for stuff to happen. Here and there, maybe like, oh, 2 minutes, stand up, take a water break, you know? That's cool. But like, the idea of this game isn't, oh, I gotta wait for more yellow research and rocket parts and brah, 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 brah. Again, no insult to Factorio or other games like that. Those are really, really good games, but I feel this game is almost in a different category all on its own. Yep, this'll fully saturate the line. Which is good, because we're overproducing for the eventuality of more stuff later. Okay, and I need... How have we been doing it? Like this? Okay, and this is all going to merge into its own separate deely-deely-do. So let's combine this up. And another merger like this, and another merger like that. I keep calling them mergers because that's what I'm using them as. These are really called balancers. So please don't get confused with my brand of dumb language, but I'm really calling this device for its purpose and not what it's actually called. That's all good. That looks all good to me. Cool. Do I need to plug in these other lines? No, we have 100% saturation. Whoa. You've unlocked the chaining extractor. It can forward its resources to other extractors so you can more efficiently extract. Oh, cool. Okay. So this is an easy way to deal with those middle resources. I love it. Cool. Oh, so to finish my previous thought, do I have to combine any more of these lines? I mean, not really. I mean, we have 100% saturation on the line here, but I want to get this all hooked up so I don't forget to do it later. And it's like, why am I not producing as much as I could? Oh, I didn't hook everything up. Yes. Every time I say that, I want to sound like Cutman from Mega Man, the animated show. Cutman. You know, dumb... stereotypical evil scientist, I guess. I don't know. Cutman. I don't know. I'm going to hook up all the pieces and then it's going to be more efficient. Yes. I don't know. I'm a weird duck, that's for sure. Okay. Not too much more for this. Do I have enough room is the question. Doesn't look like I do. Shucks deluxe. So that's okay. A little bit of finagling. I think we can get this to fly. Just button that up. Oh, that's an interesting conundrum. But a conundrum we'll wait and solve in a minute. This is literally another example that one more square of difference could have saved me this little bit of headache here. But this isn't a problem. Oh, let's see here. I know exactly how I'm going to solve this. I'm gonna do a little bit of jiggery pokery, which is what my old business analyst used to tell me, because he wasn't a developer and I wasn't a business analyst, and he's like, hey, these numbers aren't adding up, and I'm like, what was the formula you gave me? What did you want me to do? And I did the work, and I did the code, and it didn't come out the way you wanted. He's like, hey, we need some more jiggery pokery to get this thing to work. It's like, what does that even mean? And he's like, you know, you gotta poke around with it a bit more. You gotta change the variables or whatever. I'm like, okay, cool. Jiggery pokery, I like it. This is a beautiful sight. I'm gonna hang on. Print screen. I don't know if there's a screen. Is there a screen cap button, like, for reals? Nope. Okay. That's fine. I got a screen cap. I'm going to add that to Twitter or something later. That's my new screensaver. I'll just record this for like 5 minutes and that's it. I used to do the same thing with Factorio with my main bus. All the resources coming, going, all that stuff. Super cool. Okay, that is project done. How are we looking on the production side? That's slick as heck. I can get rid of the latest tab. How are we on the actual... Okay, so these stats don't retain. They get flushed every single load, which is fine. 708, that's not bad. I like that. 10 plus a second, that's brilliant. And that will unlock for us cutting, rotating, and stacking, which is good. Next, we have to work on... Wait, what level are we? Oh, level 12. Ah, blueprints, excellent. Okay, now we have to deal with this thing. What is this thing? Three circles and a square of blue and a white circle. How do I make white with three colors? Well, the only logical conclusion is combine them all, right? Isn't that color theory or something? I don't know. Anyway, let's see if we can find this circle, circle, square. Oh, we're close. Half circle, half square. Half circle, half square. I really want to see if we can find another half circle, half square, a quarter circle, three quarters square. We're going to do the same thing we did last time. I'm going to do some idle searching around. We're going to see if we can find the parts we want. If we can't... Oh, so close. If we can't find the parts we... Oh! Aha! Let's call that possibilities. Oh, what was this? Not sure. Oh, hey! That's also a thing we need. Where is this in accordance to the hub? How far away did I go? Wow. Okay, and where is this one in accordance to the hub? A lot closer. I think I want this one. Okay. So in addition to this, I also need... Oh, circle right there. Awesome. Yep. This is what we are doing. Call it latest so I don't lose track. Everything just looks so good. I could just get literally lost just staring at all the stuff coming in. Yep, 100% saturation all the way through. That's awesome. These little units could use a boost. Let's just take a quick gander at them. What is taking so long? Okay, we're having some shortage issues here. Just slap bang this together real quick. Okay. So maybe this is where we work with the chain extractor. So how does this work? Extractor. Chain extractor. I don't know why it wouldn't just default to chain extractor, but whatever. Oh, okay. Yeah. Let's just run a little test here. Yes, it's literally producing twice as much. Cool. And we're gonna do something like that. Okay, it looks like I've maximized out this resource in its entirety. Huh. That's incredible. Man, so many balancers. I'm just gonna leave it, I think. Is there more that I can change here? Yes, we still have a ton of stuff coming in. Let's add another chain here. Boom, ba-doom, boom. Efficient? Probably not at all. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 going that way and 4 going this way. I can't divide that any better. I mean, that's just exactly how it's going to be. Uh-oh. 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 Well, actually, this isn't going to block anything up. It's just going to make it all the way, and that's going to be that. I forgot to rotate. I'm a silly Billy. I completely forgot my own rules. There we go. Yeah, so what'll happen is it'll get stored into the system, and then nothing will really happen to it. So it'll say, yeah, here. So this is stuff that I accidentally shoveled into the system, and it's stored, but it's never required, so nothing happens with it. So there's no real such thing as a blockage. It just makes it all the way through and then just gets stored. Why am I still getting half pieces? Oh, for gosh sake. That would be why. There we go. Okay, so two corrections I've made after I messed them up anyhow. Excuse me. Okay, everything looks fine here. All good, all good. Let's just make a quick spot check. This is kind of how I do it. The game moves fairly quickly now, and it's hard for my eyes to trace what's going on, so I just stop it real quick, take a quick look at the line coming in, make sure everything looks normal, just kill it. Looks good. Yep, done that enough times, pretty happy with the result. Okay, the reason why I wanted to do that is because I noticed at the hub, we had a little bit of a backlog there, but that's okay. Yep, and that's from our stoppage, and now it'll resume, and I'm sure we're going to get two more of those, or one more of those, or whatever. Yep, little oh, there we go, okay. Looks like it renormalized, so that's good. Alright, now back to this. I have this part, which needs to be rotated 90 and bluified. Okay, well, let's give our new extractors a try. Something like this, I think, is going to give us some real throughput. Not quite full saturation. What about this? That way the line bleeds out. Okay, pretty darn good. Pretty darn good, actually. Bum, bum, ba-dum, bum. Okay, this ought to give us full saturation. Yep. That does, cool. So the answer is, at this tech level, 6. Yeah, it's going to be a while before we get to better extraction or anything. So 6 is exactly the amount for 100% saturation on a singular line. So that being said, 3... 3. So this will give me 1, 2, 3, 4 completely saturated lines. Awesome. It's a great thing about games like this. I didn't do any math. I don't have scribble paper in front of me. I didn't try to logarithmatize. I tried to say, you know, on a calculator, there's a log function. I tried to use that and math or something as a word, and it didn't work. Okay, these guys need to be rotated and blued. So, I actually think the rotators are fairly slow, so we can split this out into 8. Oh, actually, I need to break this out to 12? Holy crap. So let's test the saturation level of this, right? I need this to rotate counterclockwise 90 degrees. No, that actually works really quickly. I thought it was gonna take longer, but I think I like this setup. Oh my gosh, I'm not gonna have enough room. I'm not gonna have enough room at all. There we go. Thank goodness this did not take me a lot of time. Did I count if that's 12? No, I didn't. I didn't at all. But we'll get there. We'll figure it out. Not really worried. In other games, even like Assembly Line or something, that was the car game I was thinking about before. Even like an Assembly Line or something, I was always really... Huh. No, that seems about right. I don't know why I thought I needed 12. Yeah, that I think that looks good. That's a good start. Okay, now painting. Painting is gonna now take 12. One for each output. I keep interrupting myself. Even in Assembly Line, that game very much promotes you to be very formulaic and count the numbers, do the math, figure out what is an efficient platform, and then build off of that. If you have a bottleneck, research the bottleneck, make it more streamlined, economize, modernize, you know, all the eyes, right? That being said, with a game like this, I'm having a much more delightful time because I have to worry a lot less about everything. Just go by looks. How does it look? Does it look good? Is anything looking slow? If you're not happy with it, just change it. Yeah. Easy. Okay, so now we have that row. And I think I want to do something like this. And this is going to be chaos unto itself. But I think we can manage. This is going to look smexy if I can get this to work. I don't need you. Okay, and I just need one more. So what is it? Like that? Do 3/1. Yep, that's it. That's our boy. Yes. This looks so weird. But yes. Okay. Let's plug in all the item pieces. Now, I know I'll need underneath these, but we'll save that for later. Let's just do this one step at a time. Let's plug in the parts, and then we'll come back with blue and plug in the paint. Too excited for my own good. Just whatever you gotta do, man, just plug in your paint. Okay, so now that we have the belts and all the items, now we can do the underneaths. So something like this is going to be necessary. We'll just go all the way like that. So that gets 3 here, and then we'll need something like that. Yeah, see, this is where we're going to have a bit of an issue. Actually, no, we won't. We won't at all. There we go. Good. Okay. I'm actually pretty happy with this. Yeah, something like that. Yep, and then we'll just keep tweaking as we go. Okay, let's get some color here. I need 2, 4, 6. How did I end up with 16? Right, 8 times 2 is 16. Ah, my mind is in so many places I can't keep track. Alright, so I need 16 outputs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's pull this back a little bit. So I could double up on the blue. But then my circle here, where am I gonna get white components? Red, green, I'm missing green. Green. Oh, there's green. Okay. We'll figure that out when we get that far, I think. I'm just gonna go ape crap on this blue here. Is this overkill? Abso-freaking-lutely it is. It is a jabillion percent overkill. However, I don't care. Let's start... Something like that. Giving us plenty of range and a wide berth to get everything done. I apologize, I keep clearing my throat. I think I've got a bit of a cold. Okay. Now let's see some outputs. Because that's going to be another length that I need to preserve. Yeah, see here? This is a problem. this one's not a problem. Real simple. But yeah, this is the thing we have to be mindful of also, are the outputs. So there's that. There's that. That's fine. Just this one was our danger. Our danger zone. So, real simple. We just have to take this back one. Nope, that's not what I want. That's what I want. Cool. And complicated mess you wanted? Complicated mess we got. Okay. I thought I was missing one. Cool. Okay. So we've hooked up four blue lines. That's where we're getting our blues from. So let's go ahead and finish connecting up the rest of the outputs. That'll make me feel a little more sane, I think. Okay. Now we just reconnect with all the tunnel parts, all the blue, and we're good to go. Yes. Just get this stuff moving. I could just go straight down. Why don't I just go straight down? What am I doing? That is what I want nuked. There's no real reason for me to preserve more space on the right, so don't need to. Oh, nope. There we go. Then this, very simply put, like this. Oh man, let's hope I have enough space. Oh yeah, we got plenty. We got plenty of room. Plenty of room. oh, what the crap is this? Four, eight, four. I think I did this right. We'll know better once the system starts moving, but this looks correct to me. And I didn't need to make this wide berth. I could pull it all the way back and compact it if I cared about it. It's really not that big of a deal. Okay, so now we've got a little bit of finagling to do here. But that's okay. None of this is impossible. We just have to take a smart, educated, practical look at this and not freak out. That's another thing that's really important about a game like this. Don't freak out. Nothing is ruined. Absolutely everything can be undone, redone, reduxed, refilled, unfilled, whatever. None of this is game-breaking, broken amounts of damage. Let's peel this back. Good. Oh, let's see here. How are we going to handle all of this? Crap. I think I needed one extra square to make this all 100% copacetic. But that's okay. So this one I can move. I think. Cool. Yeah, see, the problem is now we've got a blockage because there's another device that has to be there and it's in the way. Shucks. Shucks deluxe. Well, let's see if we can adapt our way around it. Oh, we sure can. We sure can. There we go. Easy. This is a problem. Once we get blueprints, I think I'll build one part of this and then just copy stamp it all the way around town. Until then, nut bunnies. Okay. So we're just gonna clean that out. That looks like that. That looks like that. And to reconcile, real simple, that looks like that. That can stay there. Okay, so I'm working down and up, right? That's the plan. I kind of want to just trash these so they're not in the way, but whatever. That way I can see from what's moving and flowing over what isn't. Ba-bum-bum-bum. Okay, that's all fixed. Okay, next line. Oh, you're just very simple. You go there. You go there. I need you to go all the grand spanking way over there. Bum bum bum. I know I'm making this look incredibly complicated, because this is incredibly complicated. How far do you go? Oh, not really far enough. Shoot. Cool. Excellent. Easy. Keep saying that, even though this is incredibly interesting. Okay. Good. Good, good. Let's just doctor that up right there. Boom. Okay. We got our blue tri-decafrica spheroids. Cool. Still acceptable. Neat. Okay, we only have four more of these jerk butts to plug in, and then we are done with this 1/10 of the project. There we go. Wait. I missed a line somewhere. Yep. Shoot. I totally missed a line. Oh, that makes sense. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That is correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, crap. I screwed something up real bad. Like, real, real bad. Okay. Let's take this one line at a time. These four lines, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. I verify those are correct. The next four. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. Yes. 2. Nope. Okay, so the way I have this stacked, this wasn't going to work this way because of the layering. I see the error now, which is unfortunate. Yep, this one wasn't going to work because it requires blue on two lanes. So the thing is, I'm using all the blue, right? I'm just not using all the spheres. 1, 2, 3. Actually, this guy's extra. So I'll have an extra of each. And the problem is because this lane has 6 in it. If it had 5 in it, it wouldn't be a problem. But it has 6 in it. And my spacing needed to be 1 extra on this Y axis here. So if I spaced it out 1 more, this wouldn't have been a problem. That's okay. That's okay. So I'm going to take this guy and go like this. And just to recognize that there's something wrong there, I'm going to hook up the rest of the lines. We're going to fix this issue. And then I think I'm going to call it an episode. wacky, wacky, wacky stuff. You can go there, sure. Okay, that's hooked in. I'm missing one more. Yeah, just one more. Cool. And then we can move on with unscrewing up whatever our screw up was. Man, I can't believe I missed that one thing. Just a little bit of blindsidedness just took me for a ride. Took me for a hell of a ride. Can I expand these out any farther? That one I can, and that one I can. And that one I can't. And this one technically doesn't matter. So this'll work. Yeah, it doesn't go that far. That's okay. Let's just do a little cleanup here. Okay. So it's all working except for this one. Oh, actually, this is the only one in this column. So actually, I think I have a very easy fix for this predicament. Yep, perfect, okay, easy fix. Yep, so that was my whole problem. Because I went 6 in a row like this, that was my issue. 5 would have been fine. 5 would have been perfect, but 6 was too much. All right, we have the basis of these blueprint toids. I don't know what the heck we want to call them. I don't even know what they are, but very good addition. Little bit of legwork needed to get the job done, but we've got a ton of them. Next episode, we're going to be working on the rest of the puzzle. These white layer thingies. Oh, another upgrade. Excellent. Cutting, rotating, stacking. Boom. Just get it done. Heck, what in the hell is this? Oh my god. Cut it in half, then cut it in half again, then stack it, paint it. Oh my god. Is there going to be, like, stacks of, like, 7 items? Because I don't know if my brain can handle that. Anyway, gonna call this here. Thank you for joining me. My name is John Megacycle. Another episode of Shapes.io is in the books, and I hope to catch you next time. Hey there, guys, gals, fans, and pals. Thanks for checking out my video. I also want to take a moment to thank all my supporters and donators, and if you'd like to join up with me and game with my crew, all the information to get connected is in the description below. Thanks again, and I hope to catch you next time.